Thursday morning, and the first round of Lancaster started today. Actually, they're shooting right now. The first line. I am currently getting ready to head out. Just getting everything together, making sure I have everything that I needed. Don't need these scorecards. But anyways, we're getting ready to head out to Lancaster. Super exciting. It's always super exciting to go and to shoot in it. So I'm excited to get there. Though I am not excited on leaving my little girl. Because just an update, she was born last week. Look at that sweet little girl. So she was born last week, and we brought her home last Thursday. Luna, baby. Luna, baby. What are you doing, honey, buddy? That's my other baby. He's on your back, girl. He's on your back. And then that's the other man in the house. The old man, him and I, the two old men in this house. And I'm surrounded by a woman, a girl, and then the wife. Oh, bless you. So, I'm obviously going to miss my family. I always hate leaving. It's always tough leaving. Just because you get comfortable and, you know, just love being around your family. So, it always sucks to leave, but it'll be fun. It's always fun to go. It's always fun to shoot in it. It's always a great experience. And with how things have shaped up to be, I feel like I have a pretty good chance, so we'll see. We never know what happens. Probably not end up making it, but we're gonna try anyways. So we're about to head out a little over a half hour and get there. I'm just watching the baby. Lauren had a doctor's appointment, so I'm watching the baby for her. Wayne will be here, my travel buddy to a lot of these tournaments. He'll be here in about half hour, 40 minutes. And we'll load the trucks up and head out. We'll have to stop and get some gas and a couple other supplies for the drive. But otherwise, we'll be on our way. So I will be rolling the whole thing. I'm hoping I'll be able to film me shooting, that I can set the camera up in one of the chairs there. And I'm just going to let it film. Just let it film the whole time I'm shooting. That way, hopefully I could post this video for y'all in case of people that haven't gone or, you know, just want to see how we do. So I will see you guys soon. What is up, guys? We are about halfway there to Lancaster. Been driving for a couple hours now. Just only a couple more to go, so maybe a little more than halfway there. But so far, everything's been going good. Not too much traffic, luckily. Got Wayne up there behind me, so hopefully we'll be there soon.
Yeah, right. Yeah. guys yesterday, and they were saying that they kept the score in paper, but they used this to do the totals. Like, so you didn't have to do the math as they went. That's smart.
Okay. Yeah.
Well, they're saying that paper's the official one.
Yes. So they have the match, but, I mean, just the totals.
So Homer is Andrea, you, me.
Yep.
Okay.
Let's see, yep. And you call the order out, and the arrows get called in the order you're shot. Not highest to lowest.
Thank you.
I didn't see that. Oh, I know what? I thought it was close there, so that's how it went off. I'm like, oh. So, yeah, I didn't. When I was done, I saw the name popping up, but I got to have it come on and wait for my name. I'm like, oh, crap. I didn't make sure to touch you, write down another name. I'm like, oh. Are you here by yourself? Or? Oh, I didn't even do that. Oh.
So
it is Friday around 4 o'clock. Just an update, I am on my way home because unfortunately I got eliminated. I did not qualify to move on to day two at Lancaster, which is fine. You know, I obviously would have loved to make it and shoot day two in the shoot-ups, but just wasn't in the cards. Still getting used to this bow, still working out a few kinks that I have. I'm not too upset with how I shot. I shot pretty good for the most part. Honestly, what killed me was just not enough X's. If I had just a few more X's, I could have most likely made the cut. I mean, I'm right there at that cutoff part to move on to day two. You know, man, it's, to be honest, the men's open class and a lot of games in this sport, the men's open class is so big. Sorry, guys, the camera's gonna move. Like I said, I'm driving. Don't have my usual tripod, so it's a little wobbly there. I apologize. But I was saying, the men's open class, especially for Lancaster, there is 3,000 people that go to that tournament. The largest class is that men's open class, and you're figuring a couple hundred people. I mean, it's got to be at least like 400, 500 people, something like that. I actually should look it up and find out. But it is huge, and there's so much awesome talent, which is cool, but it's so flooded that you really got to be on to make it through. And that's with a lot of other things that I've seen. Like IBO, for instance, if you shoot the MBO class, flooded. I mean, that's pretty much like shooting up. Lost you there. Jesus. Sorry, like I said, not the best mounting system right now. The MBO class and IBO is just completely flooded. You're so overrun with people, tons and tons and tons of people. It's just, it's tough. It's tough competition. It's also tough in a few other ways. So, I'm not necessarily saying this is the case, but in the amateur classes like MBO for IBO or the men's open class here at Lancaster, there really isn't anything keeping people from taking some kind of performance enhancer or some kind of anxiety killing medicine, you know, say like Xanax or something to calm their nerves down. There's nothing to regulate it or to prevent people from doing it. I've actually been against people. And I keep going to IBO. Obviously, this is the Lancaster Classic that I was shooting. I'm just using what I've seen at other national tournaments, which the IBO, I do tons of them every year, traveling all over. But I personally seen in my own class and in my own group that I'm shooting with of guys who would have a few drinks before their scoring round. You know, and that's, You can imagine how much that takes anxiety away, pressure away, stuff like that. You know, and it's not allowed, but there's also really nothing stopping it. Sure, I could have gone to someone and said, hey, you know, I went to a range official or something and said, hey, you know, this guy is drinking, blah, blah, blah. They would have taken action and done whatever. I hate being that person. I'm not necessarily that person, but that's the thing that can also play against you in some of these tournaments. Not necessarily saying that it definitely is, but you know that there's no testing, there's no stuff. If someone has access to something to really kill their nerves and kill their anxiety while they're on the line, whatever it is, it doesn't matter. Name whatever you could think of. There's even some blood pressure. Sorry guys, this is like the most jerry-rigged freaking camera. There's even blood pressure medicines, which is off of, or which is on the list of medicines that you cannot take when you get drug tested by, like, in the Olympics, or even when they do drug testings, like at Vegas and stuff like that. There's blood pressure medicines that do literally calm your nerves, and it's controlling your blood pressure, so it's keeping you from getting a higher blood pressure, like when your anxiety goes up, when you're in a high pressure situation, stuff like that. Anyways, not to ramble on about it, my point is that is part of the thing that plays against you in the amateur classes, like even the semi-pro classes and all that that I participate in. It's tough, man. You it's just tough. It's tough to compete, especially when you're on the straight and narrow, like don't do anything, completely clean and sober. You don't take any narcotic medicine, anything like that, that would be in your favor, especially in a high-pressure situation. When you don't do any of that and stuff, it's just your shooting. And sure, you could still, most of the time, outshoot these guys. And I know I'm perfectly capable of beating most of the people out there. My biggest problem that I'm trying to work on is my head. I can't even tell you in the past, let's say 3 weeks, how many 300 rounds I have shot in the past 3 weeks. Just back to back 300 rounds. Just killing it. Just fucking pounding the X. And at home, it's the same like other people say. Oh, at home, I'm pro, I'm an all-star at home, blah, blah, blah. And then they go to other events like this and they don't do it. It's because of the mental game. It's tough. It really is tough. I felt really good today, which I'm really happy about. There was a couple of times on the line that I felt a little bit of pressure, would have a little bit of anxiety build up and get to me. But for the most part, I'm actually pretty happy with my performance. I had a couple of bad shots, a couple of, not so great shots, which luckily I know exactly what I did. It's just they weren't strong shots. I got weak on the shot, I got tired, I got lazy, I guess, subconsciously lazy, even though I wasn't being lazy. It just wasn't falling through, just let it fall, didn't let down when I should have, stupid stuff like that, Also, Lancaster for me is usually the first national tournament of the new year. So it's coming off of months of not going to these big national tournaments. And all that time of not being in it, you try to jump back in. You're always going to, it's just like a freaking surge of adrenaline just hitting you, because like, just surges your system that you're all of a sudden back into this mix of, thousands of people around you, TV cameras everywhere, shit like that. It just adds to, your anxiety, adds to play against your mental game. That's all it is. You gotta have a strong mental game to do well in archery, especially target archery. Sure, it matters some in 3D, but you're shooting one arrow at each target. Unless you're doing field, obviously I was saying 3D, but field, you three targets or three arrows, which is why I like field more. You get to shoot more arrows. You shoot paper targets at longer distances outside. You have all the elements playing against you, which you do with 3D, but you have one arrow at each target in 3D. So all you got to do is keep it together for that one arrow. When you're doing target archery, indoor archery, you got to keep it together for 60 arrows, or 30 arrows, or 120 arrows, whatever it is, whatever round you're shooting. You got to keep it together back to back to back to back for each one of those arrows you shoot. So So the mental game, I can't stress enough, that is the biggest, biggest, biggest thing to work on. It's the biggest thing I've been working on, and I've been getting better at it. So, just wasn't in the cards for me this weekend. But it's fine. I had a good time. You know, it was fun. I always love going. I always love the experience, being there, shooting with everybody. Dan McCarthy was right next to me. I talked to him a bunch today. Nick Cappers was right there with me. And that's really cool. It's so cool to be next to these guys. You know, that I've been lucky enough to meet and talk to a bunch. Super awesome guys, super nice. You know, it's, and to be on a line with them, see how they shoot and stuff like that, it's just, it's cool. It's cool to be with them. Even though I'm hoping next year, I believe, will be the year that I go into the pro class. Just had enough of this, you know, the amateur class with some of the things I was just saying. It's, just gets frustrating sometimes, and at least the pro class is a little more buttoned down to prevent some of these things from happening. So anyways, that was Lancaster. Fairly happy with my shooting, did well. Just missed the cut to get it, to get in for day two, which is fine. This was the first time being away from my wife and daughter since my daughter's been born, so, and she's only been born for a week and a couple of days. So like 9 days, 10 days today. So that was on my mind as well. And I couldn't really sleep last night being away from mom. And it all adds up. You know, it's just, it is what it is. I had a good time. So, yeah, I appreciate you guys watching. And I will see you next time.